In this next series of videos, we're going to explore how to add notification rules to your asset framework database. This environment is the Calendar Techniques asset-based PI example kit. In this example kit, you can see we have a facility. It's called Westfield. We have a few multiple calendars that we can take a look at. And at the bottom, we can see that we have a production line with, it looks like, 3 widget makers. In the interest of making these examples as general as possible, we've just decided to call the production unit a widget. Let's take a look at one of our widgets and see what kind of attributes we have on it. What I'd like to point out here is that we have an inspection due date, and an inspection status attribute. These 3 attributes correspond to whether the widget has been inspected or whether an inspection needs to be performed. In order to make it easier for our inspectors to take a look at each of these widgets, we'll set up notification rules. Notification rules will allow the inspectors to receive an email
anytime these widgets are due or overdue for an inspection.
In this way, it'll be much easier for inspectors to keep track and make sure that they perform their inspections on time. As of Notifications 2016, notifications are now based off of event frames.
What this means is that you'll need an event frame to create notification rules. This article, found in the Live Library for PI Server 2017 R2, shows the relationship between notifications and event frames. Again, after the rewrite of notifications in 2016, you can see that these are all based off of event frames. The way that we get the event frames can differ. In our case, we're using number 1, the analysis service, to generate our event frames. You could also have an event frame generation interface, custom AFSDK app, or manually created event frames. All of these you can use to create notification rules off of and send notification alerts.
Let's take a look at how we can build out an event frame analysis as a template to use for our notification rules.
To begin configuring my notification on a template, I'll move over to the Library tab. I'll go to the Widget Maker Element Template. And over on the Notification Rule Templates, I'll create a new notification rule. We're greeted with a red exclamation point saying that we need to configure a trigger for this notification rule template. This is going to be based off of an analysis, and it's going to be off an analysis that we've already created. I can select the analysis template in this drop-down menu, and I'll use inspection due event frame. I'll expand what this analysis does. On my system, I have limited space to show it off, but on your systems, you should be able to see it a bit more clearly. It appears I have a start trigger for inspection status is equal to due, with the severity being information, and a second start trigger where my inspection status is equal to overdue, where the severity is major. So we're increasing in severity off of these 2 start triggers. The end trigger is when the inspection status is not equal to due and not equal to overdue. We have this set up to be event triggered. That means as soon as the status changes to due or overdue, we're going to open up our event frame and we're going to send in a notification. A few things to note at the bottom. You can see that we have a resend interval as well as a non-repetition interval. You can use the resend interval to resend the notification if the event frame has not been acknowledged or closed within a certain amount of time. You can also set a non-repetition interval. This would make sense if you do not want to receive multiple notifications for what you may consider to be one event. What I mean by this is if you have a value that hovers close to the threshold that would send a notification, you can set a non-repetition interval. That means that you will not be notified every time it crosses over the threshold for that specified non-repetition interval time. And this will become clearer when you look at the graphics displayed on the screen. Likewise, in the bottom right, we're able to be notified with a few different criteria based off of how our child event frames are created when we use multiple trigger conditions. There's more information about all of this in the Live Library, and I recommend you take a look at this in order to make sure that you specify your resend, non-repetition, and child event frame specifications correctly. When we're all done configuring our trigger, we'll click OK. In the next video, we'll explore configuring our subscriptions, as well as some new features that come with AF 2017 R2.